way harder to get through than the first one was.
It's so slow, it's got a lot of padding. Oh, well, we already getting forewarned about that dog.
Yeah, right.
What's his name, Andretti?
Yeah, like Michael. And it's probably supposed to be Andretti, and his dumbass says Andretti. Because the actor who's Andretti.
Look at this greaseball.
Dude, he's a security officer.
Oh no!
We already know the leprechaun is gonna straight up ride those go-karts though. Oh, that's established.
I hope so.
You know he will.
What else would they have in
the track? There he is.
Track?
Oh, I thought that was a leprechaun.
Okay, there is no way that's. Okay, I'm about to say he's on the.
You ain't think the slide is getting old. Believe me, son, I want me go!
Why? Bitch! It's too lit. It's too lit up.
Now I'm dealing with God.
Second one in, I'm already like, yeah.
Oh, my first wish is fine.
But I feel like it started. It didn't start that bad. Like, I just, man.
Where is
oh. It's coming.
It's got a lot of filler.
I want me gold!
I think I know something good. The whole movie. Leprechaun 2, one of the best films I've ever seen.
Yeah.
You disagree?
Yes. Yeah, that movie was terrible.
Okay, what do you guys think? Leprechaun 2, just finished it. They didn't like it.
It went down.
Quick. It went downhill.
We were on a high point after the first. Like, this won't be too bad. All that energy has been sapped.
It's getting slow. Yeah, it's hard.
And what's sad is you see him a lot more.
It still went fast, though. If you would tell me that we have watched two whole movies
already,
I would say that's crazy.
Yeah,
because the time's gone by really
fast.
There
weren't even a lot of kills in that one.
I mean, the best part to me was the very beginning, the prologue.
No, the best part was the explosion.
You said you were struggling to find good parts. There were high points. There was the black lady yelling at him.
That was good.
You forgot lawnmower death.
That was the best part of the movie.
Lawnmower Death was the most memorable. Shout out to Chris Mackey, who told me about Lawnmower Death when we were about 10 years old.
Described it perfect.
I've been waiting for till I'm 30 to watch it.
Saved it up.
For lawnmowers and boobs.
Yeah. The boob lawnmower kill was awesome. I liked the explosion. A highlight for me, if any of you guys have seen these or want to watch them, the actress that plays the girl... She is amazing. Like, she is one of the worst actresses with the weirdest voice.
Her
but
voice.
It's mesmerizing.
It's like a Muppet voice.
It is. It was like, come on, Bill. Let's run. Let's go, Bill. Cody, come on.
And not in a dumb sounding way. Like
no, like a deep.
It's like a deaf person, pretty much. Like a deaf person. Yes.
Kind of, yeah. They blow him up at the end. He's allergic to rod iron.
His rod iron is his weakness. So they went up in terms of his weaknesses a little
bit. That's
better.
True.
Yeah.
His weakness better.
Because they knew it was stupid in the first one, I guess.
But they still like, have
to keep it.
They said, the four-leaf clover, it's really limited.
Yeah, it is. You can't do a whole lot. And where are you going to find one in the city?
Yeah.
But they still had a nod to it with the go-kart, no clover sign.
There was a lot of go-kart riding in this one. It just had that very, it reminded me of a full moon, kind of straight to VHS movie, a lot of filler, dialogue.
So 90s,
just kind of slow at some parts, but then the parts where you're supposed to get ramped up, they just come off as cheap. The actors don't seem to have any energy. They didn't seem to believe it.
They must have had the same damn composer.
The music was garbage.
I wouldn't be surprised if they just reused some of the stuff from the first
one. The bar scene was weird.
Yeah.
When the black midget comes in.
African-American midget.
African-American leprechaun. That's what it's credited as.
Yeah, he was credited that there was an African-American leprechaun. And it was, what's his name?
Tony Cox.
Tony Cox,
is that
I think.
Right?
Yeah.
From
Bad Santa.
Bad Santa, yeah. And he was weird. Was it implying that he's a real leprechaun?
Yeah, because he said, I'm 5,000 or something like that.
Yeah.
It's
none
very
of his
weird.
Scenes made any sense.
No.
It seemed like it was a tour of LA, like the different parts of LA. Like, let's go see the club scene. Let's go see the
right.
coffee
That's
scene.
What it reminds
let's go see the like yuppie scene with the dude who got his finger ripped off. It's
yeah.
like every little walk of life in LA got featured in this.
Right. It reminds me of Jason Takes Manhattan in that you could tell they had intentions for something bigger, different scene. They had set pieces, certain scenes, and then there was so much filler.
Didn't work out.
No.
Yeah, overall, I would say it was pretty bad. I think if you would have rented it when you were younger, you would have enjoyed it. It would have been fun to see as a kid. But this is like one of those horror movies you could definitely show a kid. I mean, it's got some nudity at the beginning, but
right.
it didn't have anything. It was like not scary. Not that it would be.
I mean, and it
looks
like a movie.
Yeah.
Like when they're in his cave at the end, it looks like a set. I mean,
it looks
a bad set.
Bad.
Yeah.
If they all are going in this direction or downhill from here, it's not going to be good.
Yeah.
It's not a good sign. I think we all got tired on that one.
And his look is quite a bit different.
He looks different, yeah.
His outfit's different, his shoes.
He wasn't
hair.
Focused on his shoes as much.
He has some Freddy head.
He did have a bald head in this one.
Yeah, they cut out the shoe stuff.
The makeup looked pretty good.
Yeah, there was way less shoe stuff.
There was a good kill with him making a pot of gold appear in the guy's stomach and then cutting it out.
Yeah, that stomach looked like dog shit. And the most disgusting part was the tongue lick.
Oh, that tongue lick was real
gross.
Like slime and bubbles came out of his mouth.
That wasn't good.
Well, no. That,
they
honestly,
do have pretty good effects.
The effects are pretty good. Mm. I mean, that... They have to be, otherwise you're doomed.
The music's terrible.
You had a couple of cameos. Yeah, I guess the
yeah,
actor
Clint
and
Howard.
Actress.
Yeah, Clint Howard and the secretary from Twin Peaks was in the movie. The old guy was pretty good.
I liked him. I thought he was good.
He was
a good actor.
Probably the highlight.
Yeah,
he was.
But the main character and the other guy that got killed, that's just a Kirk Cameron and James Spader ripoff.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'm telling you right now, I'm already tired. I can't believe there's five more to go.
Yeah.
But we're going to pop on Leprechaun 3. I read somewhere that this was the fan favorite. I don't know where these fans
what does that
are.
Mean? Yeah.
This
yeah.
is the one they like the most.
Well, I'm
going to
go with
I mean, I know
what
it means, but like, what does it mean as far as a movie? Like, what makes a Leprechaun
yeah.
film a fan favorite of the series?
Like,
I don't know.
The most kills, the most cool effects, the best.
That
folklore,
might be
part.
I mean,
the most
yeah, but it
humor.
Could be like one of those things where, which I think it was Friday the 13th, part 5. You
uh-huh.
said that it's kind of like a lot of people. Have
don't
a,
like it.
Yeah, so it could be one of those things.
But I like it.
Who knows? Well, let the torture continue.
I could
but
lay down.
One.
Yeah, Brandon had to go, so we're hanging in and trying to finish out this St. Patrick's Day torture-a-thon.
The alcohol might be coming out. So.
I just thought that I was going to have to
start
do something.
It still seems so early.
I need to medicate.
It feels like it's still so early.
It's
going to
be weird. Like
it's afternoon, isn't it?
It's noon.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it feels like it's still like 9 in the morning to me.
Right.
I remember last time at
yeah.
night you were thrown off because the day had gone by so quick
yeah.
you couldn't believe how. Like when you're at work and it's like you're there for 8 hours. You're just like, come on. Like, the time won't move. And when you're here, it's like, boom, 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 boom. They move. At least it does for me. It goes
yeah.
by fast.
That's just being at my house.
Maybe. I still will say we had fun. I wouldn't say
yeah.
there's as many wisecracks on this one. They just didn't have as much goofy stuff. It seemed like they actually pulled the goofiness back.
Yeah.
And you were expecting it, too, because we were noticing that he was like, rhyming and stuff every at the beginning
yeah.
so you thought they were going to get clever with some of his jokes and one-liners and he just started just kind of showing up and doing certain things but nothing too what was the most memorable thing he did I mean himself
I mean he had a few scenes where he did his little laugh and pop-ins and stuff
and yeah, when he
busted out
will,
that,
the goat
the
part
end,
was
no when he
good.
Busted out of that thing at the end hey. I was like surprise or whatever.
He was busting out stuff all the time came out of a refrigerator came out of the safe.
Yeah.
He was always coming at you.
That's a theme.
Yeah, it's his move, is to come at you when you least expect it.
Busting out the box in the first one.
If you did expect it, you'd punt his ass out through the window, so he's got to surprise you. But yeah, we're going to get started on Leprechaun 3, and we'll let you know.
Get your wee trouser snake back in your pants and find me gold!